fullness of your grace in the power of your name. You lift me up. You lift me up
in the fullness,
in the fullness.
Oh, my soul,
Hallelujah, hallelujah. As a child of God, we have to learn to say yes, Lord. God will send us on missions and put us through trials. And when he calls, we must say yes, Lord. We're going to put our hands together. We're going to do this song. I'm on the battlefield for my Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
Bless the Lord. I invite the church to stand at this time as we welcome our special guest, the guest of honor this evening, a young man who deserves it. And so as he comes in, I want us to do the same song, Yes, Lord, as we allow him to come through and just come as our special guest this evening. And standing guard are members of his club. That's the boys' club. So put your hands together for the boys' club, the Kingdom Boys Club. Bless the Lord. Nobody can do better than that. Put your hands together for those guys standing, dapper, ready to welcome our special guest. And I ask you to join as we sing the song again. Yes, Lord. I ask everyone, if you can stand, only if you can stand, then you stand as we take it away, musicians and praise team.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. From the bottom of my heart to the depths of my soul, yes, Lord, completely yes, my death. Yes, Lord, yes, Lord, yes, Lord, from the bottom of my heart to the depths of my soul, yes, Lord, completely, yes, my soul says yes.
One more time, yes, Lord,
yes, Lord, yes, Lord, from the bottom of my heart to the depths of my soul, yes, Lord, completely, yes, my soul says yes.
Hallelujah. Shall we bless the Lord? Hallelujah. Introduce to you one more time, Dontae, Seivwright, no longer, but Reverend Seivwright. Put your hands together as we make him welcome. Hallelujah. We also at this time invite Reverend Ryan Plummer to come and open in prayer, followed by the scripture lesson from 1 Timothy chapter 4, reading from verse 11 through to verse 16. Reverend Plummer.
Pleasant good night to each and everyone. Father, we honor you. We give you thanks for who you are. God, you are great. You are wonderful, marvelous, and amazing. God, we thank you that you have given us life, health, and strength. But more so, God, you have given us this privilege, oh God, to be in this send-off service. God, we thank you, oh God, for all who have traveled from near and far. And God, they are here with us this afternoon as we celebrate, oh God, one of the son of our soil. God, we give you thanks, we give you praise. Father, we pray that everything that will be done and said this evening, oh God, will be done to the honor and glory of your name. God, we just thank you and we praise you for everything that you will do. We bless your name and we say thanks. In Jesus' name, amen. If you have your Bibles or your phones or your tablets, turn with me to 1 Timothy chapter 4. We'll be reading from verse 11 to the end. If you can stand for the reading, please stand. And it says, these things command and teach. Take heed to your ministry. Let no one despise your youth, but be an example to the believers in word, in conduct, in love, in spirit, in faith, and purity. Till I come, give attention to reading, exhortation, to doctrine. Do not neglect the gift that is in you, which was given to you by prophecy with the laying on of hands of the eldership. Meditate on these things. Give yourself entirely to them, that your progress may be evident to all. 16 and last, take heed to yourself and to the doctrine. Continue in them, for in doing this, you will save both yourself and those who hear you. Here's a portion of God's holy word. We honor it by saying, glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost, as it was in the beginning, now and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
We'll stand together as we do the song, then forward still to its Jehovah's will. I invite the praise team at this time to do the song. We ask you all to stand as we put our hands together and open our mouth and our voices, send it out, and let us have a wonderful time as we do the song. Then forward still to its Jehovah's will.
When Israel out of bondage came, a sea before them lay. My Lord reached down his mighty hand and rolled the sea away. Then forward still to Jehovah's will. Roll the sea away.
Celebrate well, don't it? Yeah, man, we have a lot to celebrate. When we look, I look on my right and you look at before you and you see such a young man stepping out for God. It's just amazing. And so we want to celebrate well this evening. We want to worship the Lord and give God thanks this evening for our Reverend Dontae Seivwright. He was certain when everyone thought he must be dreaming. His mind was made up and nothing could stop him. Has led him to this event. I know it was challenging. I know there were times when people thought that he was too young for the job, but David. And so I invite you to stand, and I want us to shout three hallelujahs, and I mean from the depth of your heart, as we celebrate his time that he has committed to God. After three, one, two, three, hallelujah. Two, three, bless the Lord. Put your hands together and give the Lord a clap offering. Bless the Lord, bless the Lord. I read for you one more. He was optimistic about the journey. That was unbelievable for a young man. Success. He is today Reverend Dontae Seivwright. Make some noise for him. Bless the Lord. And as we continue in the celebration, I invite at this time our Reverend Bishop Robert Williams, host pastor And then followed by Sister Williams, Sister Jasmine Williams, to bring greetings. May you put your hands together and make them welcome.
Truly a privilege and a pleasure of mine to be
apart from where he now Pastor Dontae.
And we say to God be the glory. Amen, church? Amen, church? He's no longer student pastor. He's now pastor Dontae Seivwright. And we say to God be the glory. I want to thank God for this privilege this evening and want to greet you all in the mighty name of Jesus. I don't want to stay too long because I will have to come back in a little while to give charge. And I know others of you will want to say your piece, but I'm so thankful to the Lord this evening, and I'm so proud that I happen to be the pastor releasing him into ministry. I am privileged. Such a young man who is totally committed to God, a young man who loves God, and like the moderator told us a while ago, he has no questions as to who he is, what God wants for him, and what he wants to be for the Lord. Dontae has no questions. There is no wondering. The matter has been settled already, and we say to God be the glory. I thank God that as I came here in 2019, the very day I came, he was leaving for Bethel. Well, when he told me he was leaving for Bethel, you know, he spoke to me, but then I was trying to bring my head out of the clouds. And then shortly after that, you know, I really got a hold of things and understood that this young man, and when I saw him young and really young, but he didn't allow me to question his youth at all. He affirmed and asserted himself from the very get-go. And I knew that Dontae, or Pastor Seivwright, was on his way to being who God will have him be. I want to commend you, son. I want to say to God with the glory, to your family, and I want to thank God for his family. I'm going to be asking members up there of Pastor Seivwright's family now to stand. All those of you from abroad and from near and far, put your hands together for the family tonight. I know you must be feeling proud to see Dontae, you know, and I want to single out, of all of you standing, I want to single out his grandmother. Yeah, put your hands together for our grandma. And then how can I leave out Mother, Sister Seivwright, Sister Kimoy Seivwright? Oh, my God. And how can I leave out his sister, Evangelist Kimona Seivwright? Kiana, sorry. Evangelist. I call her Evangelist from now. And with all of this, our rejoicing, there is a gentleman standing in the midst of the family this evening. Praise God. I know heaven is rejoicing. I know Dontae is pleased this evening. To God be the glory. Before he ventured into pastoral duties, he is leaving his father safely in the ark of God. Put your hands together for Mr. Brother Seivwright tonight, father of Reverend Pastor Seivwright. I want to encourage all of you to be faithful, to stand by God and see God continue to work things out for you all. Amen. And Dante, the Lord bless you. Sister Williams, not well, but Lord, come Sister Mona, don't make her come by herself. Oh, come down there, meet her. All right. She's one determined, sort of, determined woman. She might not even be able to stand and speak, but she has, Dante, she has written out what she's going to say. Amen. Praise the Lord. And when she writes out, it means she sees.
David, it was who asked, what shall I render to the Lord for all his benefits towards me? I will take the cup of salvation, and I'm going to worship the name of the Lord. Dante, I soon come to you. But I greet everybody here very well. And to tell you that God has been good to me is really an understatement. Because that there is nothing that can really express how I feel about Almighty God. If I could choose all the A's, awesome, and all the others, he is A, but he's also Z. He's zealous after this girl and has brought me this far. Thanks to all of you who have been supporting me over these last 6 months. It's been that long. God has been good, and I thank you. Dante, pardon me calling you that now, for you couldn't even be my son. You'd have to be my grandson. Your mother would be my daughter. I greet you well, and I welcome you to ministry. It's the most beautiful journey you could ever have taken. It's a rough road. I think I'm the only person here who knows exactly where you are going. I know the church you are going to. I know the road from Lucy to the church you are going to, because you have to pass my house where I was born. Satisfied that the Lord is with you. As he was with Daniel, he is with you. Yes, I'm going to use the 3 D's because that's the kind of vision that has brought you this far. And for those young men who do TD, you know about 3D vision. And Daniel had that, and Dante, you have that. And yes, you were determined, and here you are. You were dedicated to the call, and here you are. You are devoted to duty, and here you are. I encourage you this afternoon, this evening, to preach the word Dante in the hills of Clarendon, where there are no taxis or minibuses, where there are no posh cars and no nice rides for you to get. In the bushes of where you are going, preach the word. Don't be instant in season and out of season. Money or no money. Clothes or no clothes. Food or no food. Preach the word in season. Reprove. Rebuke. Do God's work. There is nothing better than one who has been won for the Lord. There is no greater reward. I send you forth with God, and on behalf of Orain and Ornicia, we know you will do well as long as you do what you love to do, that is, preach the word and shepherd God's people. God bless you, Dante. I can't come up there to hug you up, but I love you very much. Thanks to you family, for nurturing him on our behalf. He's no longer yours. He's all of us. Son, God bless all of you. Thank you.
Bless the Lord. Put your hands together one more time for Reverend and Sister Williams. Bless the Lord. It's my task also to greet everyone this evening. So I just want to greet you all well. Thank you for coming to this special occasion. I'm going to ask, as I greet you well, I am smiling. I'm going to ask you now to greet somebody beside you and smile with them. Tell them something nice. Come on, everybody. Can I do that? No, everybody, you got to do it. And smile. If they don't smile, tell them they need to smile. All right, you did that? You did that? And anybody didn't do it? All right, so I'm seeing some smiles. I also want to greet our district churches. So we have Greenland, are you here? Bless the Lord. When I call you, just shout a shout. Let me hear you. Greenland, are you here? Bless the Lord. Askinish, are you here? Dundee Penn, are you here? Dundipen, Medley, are you here? Bless the Lord. And Richmond, I know Richmond is here also. Are you here? Bless the Lord. Do we have anybody else or any other church here? Any other? Bless the Lord. All right, I think they soon come. Put your hands together, Lucy, and make them welcome. Show that we know how to welcome our visiting friends. Thank you very much. That was indeed good. It's now time for greetings. Bless the Lord. But I'm not seeing the greeters. Bless the Lord. So I want to do something because I have it here, you know, that he dressed the part even before reaching the goal of a minister. Dapper, dapper suit and all. Lovely colors, neat and noble and all. From afar and or even close, you look at the man and you see proudness. Him tell us straight up, I am a minister. When you see him, you look at him boot, them look good. And you look at him jacket. But tonight, people, look at this jacket. It has a one, not you? It looked like it come from foreign to move into Clarendon. But this a Lucy jacket, but we send you off. I want Dontae to stand and take a little time and turn. Musician, give him a little music. I want him to rock and turn. And let us see how dapper him looking. Look from head to toe. The colors blend, the boot match, and the socks match. Make some noise for Dontae Seivwright moving into. You got to turn. Oh, you can't hardly move. All right, him pass. Him look good, not you? Him really look good. Yeah, man. Yes, man. And remember that this is one new suit. But remember, him going to preach every Sunday, and him going to go out. So guess what happened? Don't forget to buy more suits. All right? Bless the Lord. I'm going to ask you all to stand at this time, and just give me 1 second. Bless the Lord. I'm going to ask you all just to stand at this time. Bless the Lord. Hallelujah. Bless the Lord. I'm going to ask us just to, I just want us to just close our eyes for a minute and just imagine I'm Reverend Dontae Seivwright, Pastor Dontae Seivwright, in his ministry. And I know that it's not going to be easy. Sister Williams said it a while ago. So I want you to just point at him and just say, bless him, Lord, 3 times. Thereafter, don't do it yet, we're going to invite Celine Robinson. She's coming with a dance. And immediately I'm going to ask Sister Rafaelita Cunningham to come and introduce for us our special speaker who will give the charge tonight, which is our own Bishop Robert Williams. So I'm going to ask you at this time, close your eyes and then stretch to him. And we are going to say, bless him, Lord, 3 times. 1, 2, 3. Bless him, Lord. 1. Bless him, Lord. 2. Say that last one stronger now. Bless him, Lord. Hallelujah. Somebody shout hallelujah. Bless the Lord. Hallelujah. I invite you now to put your hands together and welcome Celine Robinson doing a dance at this time. Bless the Lord.
on the battlefield for my Lord. I'm on the battlefield for my Lord. I will fight till I die. I never run away. I'm on the battlefield for my Lord. I'm on the battlefield for my Lord. I'm on the battlefield for my Lord. I will fight till I die. For my Lord, I'm on the battlefield. For my Lord, I will fight till I die. I never run away. I'm on the battlefield for my Lord.
Bless the Lord. In the interest of time, I'm going to invite at this time Sister Raphaelita Cunningham to do the introduction. Then we'll have the dance, and then afterwards, Pastor will come to give the charge. Put your hands together for Sister Raphaelita Cunningham. No, that a finke finke. Put your hands together and make her welcome. Thank you.
And good night, my brothers and sisters. Greetings. Greetings to our able chairperson, Sister Sandra Brown. Greetings to our guest of honor, Pastor Dontae Seivwright. Greetings to the family, all of my church family and friends and those from the district. Greetings to you all. The task is mine to introduce our guest speaker, Bishop Robert E.I. Williams. Is a Trinidadian by birth. He grew up in St. Vincent and was raised by his maternal grandfather and his wife, aided by his uncle and his wife. He grew up in the church and served in all the departments of the church except the women's ministries. He got saved at the age of 14 and came to Jamaica in 1982 for the purpose of going to Bethel Bible College, from which he graduated in 1985. Reverend, our own Bishop Robert Williams, began his pastoral duties at the age of 17 at the Mullet Hall New Testament Church of God in Clarendon. Bishop Robert Williams is the district overseer for the Lucea District of Churches and presently serves as the pastor for the Lucea New Testament Church of God. And Medley, sorry. He is married to his beautiful wife, Sister Jasmine Williams, and their marriage has produced two children, Oren and Ornicia, and they are the proud grandparents of four. So, my brothers and sister, our very own, our bishop, our pastor, who we love so very much, he's going to give the charge to our pastor, who is moving on. And so after Celine danced, I'm going to ask you to just stand and just welcome him to give the charge. God bless you.
Bless the Lord. Put your hands together for her. Not by might nor by power. And we stand to receive Reverend Robert Williams.
Hallelujah. Somebody lift your hands again and shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Bless the Lord. Not by might nor by power. Put your hands together for Celine tonight. Thank you very much. God bless you. You may be seated. Once again, it is good to see each and every one of you. I want to say how good it is to see the brethren from Askinish tonight, and Medley, and the brethren from Richmond. So good to see you all tonight. And Greenland, welcome. Of course, Pastor Seivwright has touched all of us. Amen? Amen? And that's why we are here tonight, to allow him to know we really appreciate him. And as we... Thank you very much. Yes, he wants to see me, which is... Okay. Yes. And thank God for the way he has Pastor Seivwright has really touched all of our lives. We all do love him. Amen. And I thank God for him. And I know in a little while you'll be getting a chance to say something to him. As I get ready to say a few words to him, a few words of charge, I want to acknowledge in our midst tonight a very special young lady. She has nothing to do with Pastor Seivwright. She doesn't know him. She's seeing him, I think, for the very first time in her life. But she is with us tonight. You know, friendship is a wonderful thing. And I speak of Marjorie, otherwise called Lattie. Please stand, Lattie, let them see you. Put your hands together for Lattie tonight. Lattie is Sister Williams, one of Sister Williams' best friends from high school. So they go all the way, and they were best friends then, and they are still best friends today. And so she's spending the weekend with us, and so she happens to be here tonight. I tell you something quickly. When I was in Bethel Bible College, I used to spend holidays in Clarendon, Sandy Bay, and the lady with whom I used to stay, Lattie would come out, you know, they were members of the same church and good friends. But I've always respected Lattie for who she was as a Christian young woman. And sometime after we lost touch, and when I started, when Jasmine and I started courting, she started telling me about this friend, Lattie, but I don't know her as Lattie. I know her as Marjorie or Jean. No, those two names, yeah. And she kept talking, I didn't know who was Lattie. So she says, it's as if Lattie doesn't pass me, I am not good to get through. So one day I was going to visit Jasmine, and at the top of the street, I saw Marjorie. We chatted. And then when I went down to Jasmine, I said, what's the name? I said, I see Marjorie or Jean. And she's saying, well, maybe it's the same person. Lo and behold, on our wedding day, or sometime after that, to realize the same Jean is the same Lattie. And I say, to God be the glory, amen. And I've learned so many lessons from that. And so we are going way back. And so the Lord bless you. Nice having you tonight, Lattie. The Lord wish you the best. Put your hands together for Lattie, please. I want to share with us tonight quickly, and I'm going to endeavor to be very quick. From the word of the Lord. Turn in your Bibles to the book of Jude. And
while you're finding Jude has only one chapter.
Up on your most holy faith, praying in the Holy Spirit. Keep yourselves in the love of God, looking for the mercy of our Lord Jesus Christ unto eternal life. We say amen to the word of the Lord. Amen. Father, we honor you this evening. We give you praise, worship, and glory. We thank you for your goodness. We thank you, Lord, that we can be here this evening as we now approach your word and as I seek to speak to your servant. I pray, Spirit of God, that you will draw near and speak through me. Lord, I recognize and acknowledge that it is not by might nor by power, but by the Spirit of Almighty God. Let these words of my mouth and the meditations of my heart be acceptable now to you. You are our Lord and our Redeemer. And the people of God say amen. Amen. Somebody say amen. Amen. One more time say amen. Amen. The Lord bless you. Be seated. I want to share with us this evening from this book of Jude. And one commentator, in approaching the book of Jude to expose the book of Jude, he describes the book of Jude as one of those unbeaten parts. And he says, when tourists visit a country and they turn up to see some sights, they are in awe, pardon me, at the wonder or wonders that they will see. And they are in awe, not knowing that thousands of persons have gone before them, viewing the same thing that they are awed about. However, if some people really want to know the environment or the country which they are visiting, they need to go off the beaten path. So don't always go to the regular spots that people go. So sometimes it might do you well when you visit to take a taxi and check into one of those small hotels where you can go deeper in the country and see how people operate, and then you can see some more beautiful things up the country apart from the regular sightseeing things. He therefore goes on to say that Jude is like one of those off the beaten path tracks. And then he proceeds to explain that verse 21, which we will be looking at for a few minutes, is really like that. Jude is here telling us, and we will be looking at a phrase in verse 21, and that phrase says, keep yourselves in the love of God. And so, Pastor Seivwright, I want to encourage you, as the Lord would have directed me, as you embark on a journey, you do not even know what the next stop holds. You do not even know where the next step will take you. But as you embark on this journey, keep yourself in the love of God. Amen? This statement, or before I go on to say more about the statement, I want to leave the theme with you: staying in God's love. And whatever happens, son, as you move forward, I charge you tonight, stay in God's love. This statement that Jude wrote to the church, admonishing the church to keep themselves, the brethren to keep themselves in the love of God, is directly for the saints whom God loves. So this is for those whom God loves. God's beloved is asked to separate himself from the vanity of corruption. Corruption is coming to us in all forms and shape. Very attractive, but they are vain. As this, of course, as is described, vanity. keep yourself, separate yourself from vanity. You see, as a child of God, the contrast already is in you as one whom God loves. And those who love God are different from those who do not love God. There's a difference. Therefore, I urge you, let the contrast between you who love God and those who don't love God, let it be seen in your conduct. Let the contrast be there between their conduct and your conduct, their habits and your habits. My son, I urge you, keep yourself in the love of God. I quickly want to let you know that as you embark on this journey, you are going to be meeting many who will embark on the journey with you. But it's not all who embark on the journey with you will be of the same mind. But I urge you, keep yourself in the love of God. In keeping yourself in the love of God does not mean keep yourself loving God. It doesn't mean that you must keep loving God. But keep believing and rejoicing that God loves you. And that's the important thing. Once you know that God loves you, it makes all the difference. And let me go ahead of myself here to say, the songwriter says, when God dipped his pen of love in my heart, he wrote my soul a message he wants me to know. His spirit, all divine, saved this sinful soul of mine when God dipped his love in my heart. But I said I wouldn't tell it to a living soul, how he brought salvation and he made me whole. But then, like the woman at the well, I find I could not hide this love that God did impart. It makes me laugh, makes me cry, sets my sinful soul on fire. My son, love the Lord. Or let the love of God remember that God loves you, and keep yourself in the love of God. Be convinced about God's love for you. Yeah, man. Be convinced about it. In other words, let the love of God be so convinced that God loves you that it conquers you. And not only will it conquer you, but it will chain you, enchain you. It will chain you up. So it's one thing to conquer, it's another thing to be enchained. Let the love of God conquer you and enchain you. By this, you will be able to stand against the wiles of the devil, because it's the love of God that will be keeping you. It is the love of God that will be standing with you. The word in the text that says keep yourself in the love of God means really to guard the love of God. Protect it. Guard it. Protect it. Value it. And one writer says, guard it as if it is a part of the fortress in safekeeping. So live in this castle, Mr. M.D. Bob Cook, in his work, Thoughts for Everyday Living, he says, live in this castle of God's love, and no enemy of doubt or fear can by any means hurt you. So when you meet on life's difficult part, when you find yourself in difficult situations as a pastor, rock back on the love of God. Know that God loves you. There are times when you are going to be wondering if it really makes sense. There are times when you will work hard and it seems as if nothing is happening. You would preach and sometimes as if what you preach everything and nothing happens. I remember one Sunday morning in my first pastorate, I preached and I told the brethren, when people trouble you and do you anything, don't take revenge. Do not answer back. When people trouble you, don't always have to answer. Remember who we are. We are the people of God. At the end of the sermon, of the message, we prayed and gave ourselves to the Lord. A few minutes later, after the church was dismissed, I was still inside and heard a little commotion on the outside, only to realize that two of the brethren were having a quarrel. And we just finished preaching. Are you with me? And those times can be very discouraging. There are times when you might not have what to eat. There are times when you might not even know how to dress because you are wearing everything and you want to mix it up so that, you know. And there are times when it's going to be rough. But remember, keep yourself in the love of God. Once you know that God loves you, doubt and fear will not turn you back. I hurry on to tell you, therefore, you have a duty to keep yourself in the love of God. You have a duty so to do. The text says, keep yourselves, which means we are to be vigilant amidst the perils that will come to set us back. Be vigilant. Stand your ground. Be determined. God loves me. And so he will not take me where he will not look after me. I may be going through the waters, but he promises, because he loves me, he is with me. Be vigilant. And I urge you, my son, in your vigilance, doggedly stay the course. Doggedly stay the course. Sometimes it would seem as if, boy, it doesn't make any sense you preach to these people because where you are might be behind God's back. So it might seem. But then because God loves you, he has called you, he has chosen you, doggedly stay the course. Amen? Hear what 1 Peter 5:8 says. Be sober. Be vigilant, because your adversary, the devil, is walking about like a roaring lion, seeking whom he may devour. You see, Pastor Seivwright, we did not choose the parents that we have. We did not choose our birth. We did not choose the gifts and talents that we have. We did not choose the hereditaries we may, you know, gather from those, our ascendants. But our God-aspiring self or our God-shunning self belongs to us. So while God chose your parents and everything, it is you now to choose to either hold on to God or shun God. Remember, that's yours. And there are two ways, two sides to this keeping. First of all, there is the divine side of keeping yourself. God will help to keep you, in his love. Yes, he will. You see, for Jesus dwells in us, penetrating our whole nature with his nature. The Holy Spirit, he comes into us, and his purpose for coming is to make the presence of God more deeply felt in our lives. So, like the sun affects all of us by the heat that comes from the sun, the heat from the sun energizes us and stimulates us and causes us to move. The Holy Spirit is the one who is going to be working on your willingness. So he will work on your willing, your thinking, your feeling, as it relates to the Lord. So if you are willing, the Holy Spirit will work on your willingness. He will work on your thinking and your feeling. This is the God's part that he's going to play. And he will activate your will, your feeling. And so sometimes when you don't feel to go to church. Sometimes when you don't want to go, there were times, I wish rain fall tonight. And nobody come out to church. That gives me an excuse. And then it starts drizzling, but the rain stops. I have to get up and go. And sometimes I don't feel as if I can make it, but I get up and I go. God's love, he will enable the willingness once you are willing. He will give you the strength and the courage to go on. The love of God is in our heart. It's like fire. It's like warmth. It's like light. That will energize the dead things in our lives, the dead areas, the dead moments. The love of God will energize you. And even when things are bad and you go to church and you might only find two members in church, the love of God will make you preach as if the two is 200. And you turn up and for a prayer meeting and there's only three of you, you pray and seek God as if you are 300. It is the love of God. Let the love of God energize you. Don't look for material gain. We are human beings, yes. But I beg you, son, do not let this be your priority. Whom God blesses, he blesses. And if he calls you, he's going to take care of you. Stay in the love of God. You see, Jeremiah chapter 20, verse 9 says, "Then I said, I will not make mention of the Lord, nor speak any more in his name. But his word was in my heart like a burning fire shut up in my bones. I was weary of holding it back, and I could not hold it back." Keep the love of God burning inside your son. And when people are against you, your fellow pastor, so God will keep you, but you also need to keep yourself. Because hear what the text says, keep ourselves. This means we ought to love our God with the full force of decision and the purpose. Decide, I'm going to love the Lord. Decide, I'm going to stay in God's love. It's a deliberate decision you have to make. Because, son, there are times when it would not seem to make sense. The 1 + 1 isn't adding at all. And it seems as if you have half and half. And God is telling you the 1 + 1 when you see half. And God is telling you his 1 + 1 is 11. But your maths teacher taught you 1 + 1 is 2. God is right. Your maths teacher is wrong. Because if God says it, that's the way it is. Let the love of God keep you standing. Be forceful in your decision. Be purposeful in your decisions. Be deliberate. Our love for God must not be a vague statement to make us sound good. Too many of us say we love God, and it's a vague statement to make us sound good. But be determined. Be settled. Be determined and understand that the love of God will be commanding, compelling, and triumphing in all crises. It will be commanding, compelling, and triumphing. Let it then be your settled purpose, Pastor Seivwright, to keep your heart warm with the love of God. One writer says, and I quote, "I love the Lord with my strength. I will not permit abounding iniquity to chill my heart, or abounding prosperity to steal," that is to make it hard. "I will not allow nature, humanity, self, or idols of the world to have dominion over me, but I will love thee. I will watch, lest time and circumstances should spoil the fervor and freshness of the heart." And I close by letting you know how to keep yourself in the love of God. The best way to keep yourself in the love of God is to be always filled with the Holy Spirit. Let the Holy Spirit fill you at all times. There is nothing, or there is something about the Holy Ghost that we should always remember and admire, and that is the Holy Ghost. He discovers evil wherever evil is, and evil cannot live before him. So if you must keep yourself in the love of God, ensure that the Holy Ghost is always in control. And once he's in control, you're cool. So when he tells you to preach and what you're preaching doesn't make sense, and people might be upset because he has told you to preach and you're in the love of God, the Holy Ghost, he will stand by you. He cannot stomach evil. He will find evil where it is, because himself and evil cannot abide in the same place. I urge you, son, stay in the love of God. Stay in the love of God. I close by telling you, we are living in a highly organized age. Organized with evil. Organized with corruption. Highly organized. We are living in a world with many kinds of evils and corruption. Spiritual, moral, social, and we can name them. Be on your guard against them, so that you may not be drawn away from the love of Jesus Christ. Say like the Apostle Paul in Romans chapter 8, verse 36. Who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Shall tribulation, or distress, or persecution, or famine, or nakedness, or peril, or sword? He goes on in verse 38 to say, "For I am persuaded that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor any other created thing shall be able to separate me from the love of God." You hear what he says? None of these things will be able to separate me from the love of God. And Paul, in writing to the Philippians in chapter 3, he says, "I want to know him and the power of his resurrection and the fellowship of his suffering. So this one thing I do, forgetting that which is behind me and reaching for that which is ahead of me, I press because of the love of God. I reach because of the love of God." And in reaching, sometimes it might seem as if the more you reach, the farther it goes. But the love of God pushes you. I love God. I'm not here for myself. I'm not here for my family. I'm not here for fame. Oh God. I am not here to get a good name or to get accolades and likes. I am here to honor God. I am here. And sometimes in the backside of the desert, you might not get many comments and likes. But that's all right, son. If God sends you to the backside of the desert, go there. You never know. When you are through at the backside of the desert and he brings you to the front of the city, you come as a man under commission, a man under fire for God. But stay in the love of God. Press towards the mark of the higher calling of God in Christ Jesus. You go forward, son, as a soldier of God, the servant of God. You may be small in stature, you may be young, but you are the man of God. Walk as a man of God. Don't beg anybody to respect you. You command respect. Stand as God's servant. Don't seek for popularity and fame. Know who you are. And like I said, live or keep yourself in the love of God. To Dontae Seivwright, by or presented to you by Pastor Robert Williams, this 27th day of August, 2023. And I've written there, keep yourself in the love of God. God bless you. The good God keep you. I know you will do well. Just keep yourself. If nothing else, Dontae, keep yourself in the love of God. It is never about you. It is always about God. God bless you. I present you this Bible. As you go forth, I can't shake your other hand. So let me see. Shake the left hand. I send you forth. Go. Preach the word. This is your authority. You need nothing else. It will pull down the devil's stronghold. It will answer all of hell's question. Let it be a lamp unto your feet and a light to your path. In the name of Jesus. Somebody say the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Bless the Lord. It's now time for the lighting of the candle, which will be also led by our Reverend Robert Williams, assisted by Pastor Plummer. Bless the Lord. I invite the praise team to do the song chorus, Carry a Candle, as they made the preparation.
Carry your candle. Run to the darkness, seek out the hopeless, confused and torn. Hold out your candle for all to see it. Take your candle.
Hallelujah.
Go light your word.
I send you forth now. Go light John's hall, light Clarendon, and anywhere God send you after that, light son, light, light in the desert, light on the mountains, light in the valley, just light, live in God's love. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. Put your hands together for him. Put your hands together for the man of God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Carry a candle, run through the darkness.
I invite Reverend Plummer. Officers who are here. Hallelujah.
To see it, take your candle.
Thank you, Jesus.
Go light your word.
Sing a song.
Take your candle. Go light your word.
Carry your candle, Santa, everybody.
Carry your candle. Run through the darkness, seek out the hopeless, confused and torn. Hold out your candle for all to see it.
Take your candle.
Take your candle.
Go light your
word. Go light your word.
Take your candle.
Go light your word.
Father, in the name of Jesus, this is your son. Our God. Our God. From a young age in school, you've called him. Like Samuel, you've called him in his youth. And there were things he did not understand, and there are things he still might not understand. Yet you called Samuel, and you spoke to him, and you used him. Your son, Dontae Seivwright, kneels at this altar, oh God, for the last time in this congregation. After tonight, God, he goes into pastoral duties. You have called him. You have laid your hands on him. And so now, God, we commend him to your care. We commend him to your keeping. We commend him to your love. Hallelujah! Your love which knows no bounds. So the psalmist says, if I take the wings of the morning and go to the uttermost part of the earth, there you are. If I make my bed in hell, even there your presence will find me. So your love will carry Dontae over the mountains, through the valleys. You'll carry him on the rough waters. You will still his storms. And those that you will not still, oh God, you will part the Jordan. Those that you will not part, you will give him the ability to walk on them. So help him now, I pray. We commend him now to your care and to your keeping. Thank you, Holy Ghost. Thank you, Holy Ghost. Be his compass from here through to eternity. And we at Lucea in the Testament Church of God will continue to praise, honor, and glorify you. For you have chosen from among us a young man to serve you. Thank you, our Father. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost, go forth now and be who God will have you be. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. Hallelujah. God bless you. Just shake his hand.
Seek out the hopeless, confused and torn.
God bless you. God bless you.
Hold out your candle for all to see it. Take your candle. Go light your word. Take your candle.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. My soul is rejoicing. Hallelujah, hallelujah. And we thank our Reverend for giving such a charge that I know a Pastor Dontae will forever remember. He'll remember those words every day because he has to live in the love of God. And that's what will carry him through. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Bless the Lord, hallelujah. We are going, I'm going to go through at this time to the tributes because of time. I'm going to ask you, I know that you have a long song and everything, but because we have a number of tributes at this time, I'm going to ask you to cut down the song from a 3-verse to a 2-verse. If possible, you can do also 1 verse, and that would be really good. So we're going to move into the tributes at this time, and I'm going to invite in this order the Children's Ministry, Kingdom Boys Ministry, Yam and Teens Ministry, and the final item in the section from the Sunshine Singers. I'm going to invite you at this time to put your hands together and welcome the Children's Ministry.
I invite all the children, the teens, and the yam just to come. Children, teens, and yam. That's the youth department. We can't separate ourselves. We just love you with the love of the Lord. We just love you with the love of the Lord. We can see in you the glory of the Lord. We just love you with the love of the Lord. Oh, we just love you with the love of the Lord. We just love you with the love of the Lord. We can see in you the glory of the Lord. We just love you with the love of the Lord. Good evening, everyone. And to Pastor Dontae. Yes, it's so funny to you, not true. You soon get used to it. So it's Pastor Dontae. Good night, sir. So this is the youth department, and we just want to say thanks to you. Your gift is coming. It's coming. It's here and it's coming. You will get it before the night ends. So we want to say thank you. I can remember Dontae in my Sunday school class upstairs in the kitchen. And I remember one Sunday, I tell his mother, go and send him down a young adult class because I can't manage. He talks a lot. He asks a lot of questions. And he will secretly do things thinking that as a teacher, you're not seeing. But you know, teachers, you have to have an eye behind your head so you can see the things happening around there. So I threatened him. I tell him, I'm going to send her down the young adult class because nobody down there his size. So he can't talk and he can't misbehave. But he wasn't rude, always mannerable. I remember that about him. Respectful at all times. He will assist, he will help, especially with this set now that he's older than them. He will guide them, he will counsel them, and provide whatever advice to them. And we just want to say as a team, as a youth department, thank you, a big thank you. It is not unnoticed. We recognize, and sometimes I say, oh, Dontae did this. Some of them don't have to do nothing. I just leave them in Dante's care because I know that he knows exactly what to do because he's been led by God. And so we say thanks to you. Is the gift here? All right, the gift is still coming. It is still coming, but as I say, you'll get it before the night ends. So we all know that he's not so 100, but we still going to hug you. So one by one, the babies are going to go, yes, man, nothing is wrong with hugging another gentleman. So we're going to hug, and we just go around. Come on, and Adrianique, you can go ahead. Ariana, Renikia, I just love you with the love of the Lord. I just love you with the love of the Lord. We can see in you the glory of the Lord. We just love you with the love of the Lord. Oh, we just love you with the love of the Lord. We just love you with the love of the Lord. Oh, we can see in you the glory of the Lord. We just love you with the love of the Lord. Oh, we just love you with the love of the Lord. We just love you with the love of the Lord. We can see in you the glory of the Lord. We just love you with the love of the Lord.
Together for the children, Yams group, and the teens. This will be followed by the Kingdom Boys. Please come.
Greetings, everyone. Good night, good night. Could the KBC boys join me up here? All righty. Wow. All right, so we can truly say that I'm speaking on behalf of the group because some of the, we're still getting in order, people, so just give us a few minutes. Ready? All right, so as the KBC Club, Kingdom Boys Club, Dontae has really did a great job in leading us thus far. And we want to stand here tonight. It may be a sad moment for us because some of us might look at Dontae as a father, even though he's kind of young, you know. But we look at him as a leader and a motivational person, and we see him as a role model. I can say so myself. A lot of times I text him and I say, bro, you really inspire me to go further and more in God and stuff. And I can say so for the rest of the boys. And we are here, and because of Dontae and the rest of the ministry persons, we have done our song Sumptuous in Chariot, and we reached far with nationally, and we sang it when they came down, and so we want to do this song as a tribute before we hand you a gift, sir. All righty.
Hallelujah. I'll say He's taken me daily from glory to glory. In him will I trust. Oh, in him will I trust.
Come on, no boys. Something.
Some trust in chariots.
Some
trust in horses.
But Lord,
I will remember
the name of our God, the name of our God,
the name of our God. He is your warrior.
Yes, he is.
Yes, he is mighty. In him will I trust. In him will I trust.
defender, your shield and buckler. Your hope is built.
Can you agree with me? Firmly on him.
Firmly on him.
So we say, true mountain, true mount.
On mountains and valleys, your God is before you. So in him will we trust. Oh, in him will we trust.
So we say now.
Some trust in chariots. Some trust in horses.
But Lord,
but I will remember
the name of our God, the name of our God.
The name of our God is a warrior.
Yes, he is.
Yes, he is mighty. In him will I trust. Oh, in him will I trust.
So these parts is, some of these parts is.
Come what may,
yeah, hey,
you will never doubt him. We're fervently praying, resting in him,
because he has a track record of never failing.
Healing.
Even though the crash and the accident, in him will we trust. Almighty God, in him will we trust.
In him will we trust.
Somebody say.
Some trust in chariots.
Some
trust in horses.
But Lord,
I will remember.
Jesus, the name of our God.
The name of our God. He is a warrior.
Yes, he is.
Yes, he is mighty. In him will I trust.
Oh God, in him will I trust.
In him will I trust.
He
is your defender, your shield and buckler. Your hope is built.
Dante, firmly on him.
Firmly on him.
Jesus.
Through mountains and valleys, your God is before you. So in him will you trust. Oh, in him will you trust.
Could we join together now? Somebody say.
Some trust in chariots.
Some
trust in horses.
But Lord,
I will remember
the name of our God, the name of our God.
The name of our God. He is a warrior.
Yes, he is.
Yes, he is mighty.
In him will we trust.
Oh, in him will we trust.
Bro, we just want to say on behalf of the KBC, we would love for you to be here longer with us, but the Lord knows best. The Lord has a purpose for you. Uncle Marlon, they say purpose never dies. And indeed, the devil tried and killed you the other day, but he lost. He lost that battle, you know, bro. And we were here. When we heard about it, we felt sad. And we said, Lord, we could only pray and trust. And we know that God never leaves his servant in a bad place. He always takes care of his own. And so we want to just take our time. We did it. We looked after this and we took it from our heart. And we said, we have to do this. We had to do this. We had to do this. So on behalf of the KBC club that Dante has formed, and we really made a difference in the church and really made a change in our lives, and we are indeed happy for this. And so we want to just take this time and appreciate you and show you that we love you, sir. We appreciate and we love you. May the Lord continue to keep you, guide you, and lead you along your journey. The Lord has plans for you, great plans. The enemy may not like it and may want to fight against, but listen, some trust in chariots, some trust in horses, but in you, God will trust. Amen.
One more time for the Kingdom Boys. Bless the Lord. Oh my God, another preacher coming up and another singer. So we give God thanks. Put your hands together as the Sunshine singers will come. They're missing one, but they are going to sing at this time. Put your hands together and make them welcome. Bless the Lord.
Good evening, everyone. Hi, Tay. Okay, so the Sunshine Singers, sadly, we aren't really here. One person is off the island, one person is out of parish, and one person is sadly in the hospital. But we're going to invite Auntie Tanisha to come and sing with us. Just to share a quick memory. So this was a group from like when we were really small, and we were in like a tiny little competition with the Holy Singers, which was this really good boys gospel group that, you know, our reverend was a part of. So I remember when we'd be sent to rallies, and sometimes they'd send the Sunshine Singers, sometimes they said the Holy Singers, anytime they send them, so Dontae come and say, they send us instead. I'm like, cool, that's okay. And we'd always want to go to Sandy Bay's rally, so that one was always a competition between us. But it is really good, and it's really hard to say goodbye. Well, it's not really goodbye, but I won't be seeing you every Sunday anymore. I won't be competing to sing, because you don't really sing that much anymore, sadly. But we're going to really miss you. And we're just going to do this quick little song, Standing on the Promises, because we can clearly see that you are standing on the promises of God. Standing on the promises of Christ my King, through eternal ages let his praises ring. Glory in the highest I will shout and sing. I am standing on the promises of God. I am standing on the promises of Christ my Savior. Standing. I am standing on the promises of God. Standing on the promises I now can see. Perfect present cleansing in the blood for you. Standing in the liberty where Christ makes free. You are standing on the promises of God. You are standing on the promises of Christ my Savior. Standing, you are standing on the promises of God. You are standing on the promises of Christ, your Savior. Standing on the promises of God. You are standing on the promises of God. You are standing on the promises of God. We love you.
Bless the Lord. Bless the Lord. Bless the Lord. Put your hands together again for all the tributes that we have had so far. And I know that time is slipping, so don't worry. We are coming down. At this time, I want to greet Pastor Marlando Gordon is in our midst, and he's coming at this time with his dear wife to bring greetings, followed by greetings from student pastor Larry Anderson. Bless the Lord. Put your hands together as they come in this order. While they're coming, I'm going to ask the churches from the district to be prepared. So we'll take medley. If apologizes for not being here, we'll take Askanish and Greenland thereafter. So they'll come in that order. God bless you.
Hallelujah. Good night, Church of God. Good night, Church. Praise the name of the Lord. It is indeed a good thing to be in this wonderful service this evening. I want to apologize for our late arrival. We are coming straight from convention, but we determined in our heart that we have to be here in this wonderful service to celebrate the contribution of Pastor Dontae Seivwright, and also to send him off into pastoral ministry. I think all of us can relate tonight that in some way, Reverend Seivwright has blessed our lives. Somewhere along the journey, we can say that he has spoken a word over our lives. He has held our hand at some point and brought us along the journey with him. And Charisse and I, Rev, we just want to say we love you. We really appreciate you. And as we did in Maypen, as I did in Maypen, I'm speaking on behalf of both. Because again, she begged me not to hand the mic to her. Oh no, she has changed her mind. Praise the name of the Lord. But I want to say that the Cocoon Church and the Richmond Church, they are here celebrating with you tonight. You are loved in Richmond. You are loved in Cocoon. You are loved all over the world. And it's an indication of the call that is upon your life. And bro, I just want to say to you that as you go off into pastoral ministry, the call will attract a whole lot of things. It will attract good and it will attract bad. Use the discernment that the Holy Spirit has given you to walk according to how God has called you to walk. There are blessings and there are curses that the enemy will try to pronounce, but God is with you. Hallelujah. God is with you, Dontae Seivwright. There are those who are praying for you. Many are those who are with you more than those who are against you. Somebody praise God in this house. Hallelujah. I hand over to Charisse.
Bless the Lord. Good night, everyone. So I'm going to share a little secret. Some years ago, I don't know if long time ago, Dontae was a little annoying boy. Dontae rubbed you wrong. Dontae can be seen as an acquired taste. You know, after you get used to something, you love them and you can't stand them. Years ago, Dontae was this annoying little boy. And I was given the task one year to train the members of the teens quiz, Bible quiz competition, the team. And after spending around 2 weeks with them, camping out at Jensia's house and going through questions and eating together and laughing together and all of those wonderful things, Dontae became a good person in my sight. You know, Dontae was a friend. I understood Dontae, and you know, when I need to call Dontae, because me and Dontae have enough back and forth. You know, if Mr. Dontae, me feel like Dontae, Reverend Dontae Seivwright is going overboard, like I message him, I call him, and he has a strong personality, and I can be strong at times, but we always get back to we're good. Put it behind, and we're good. And I just want to say I appreciate that about you more than anything. The conflicts that we'd have had, the disagreements, that we have them, and then we go back to doing ministry, how God requires ministry to be done. And going forward, you're going to have run-ins with persons, you're going to have conflicts, but always keep the vision, keep the goal, keep kingdom in mind, and you will do ministry and do it well. God bless you, and I do love you, sir. Bless the Lord, and your gift will be coming to you shortly. Bless the Lord. Thank you very much.
Bless the Lord. As they're all wrapping the gifts from somewhere, corner or the other, we invite at this time student pastor to come.
Let me take the time out to greet my bishop. Yes, I want to greet all the council members and musicians and all the different churches and supporters. I greet you well in the name of Jesus. I also greet the presence of the Lord who is here with us. Yes. And I want to say I have learned so much. If I had to write a book on how much things I've learned from Dontae, I've learned so much. The first time I remember meeting Dontae, my first memory was when I came to youth fellowship and we were at the back there and he was asking me which Bible school we go. And so from there, you know, that conversation spiraled into one where we sometimes we're at the sea and we're talking about scripture, and then Dante he always say to me, I have to go now because I have a sermon to write. And until it reached a point where I say to myself, Bishop, every single day this man writes a sermon. And so he has grown so much. And I've, one of the things, this will come as a shocker to a lot of persons, but I've seen him work on the scene and behind the scenes. And trust me, he is an example to follow for the young man, young people, and he's also an example to elders. And so I want to say, God bless you, we love you, and trust me, words cannot express. And going forth into ministry, I don't know what kind of encouragement I can give to you, but to say, continue to do the work of the Lord. Continue to just live and to do everything that you can for him. And we know that hell will be mad whenever you do anything at all for him. Because when God, the purpose that is on your life is one where anyone bless you will be blessed. And anyone curse you will be cursed. And so God bless you. Love you. Blessings, Rev. Blessings.
Bless the Lord, bless the Lord, bless the Lord, bless the Lord. We invite the churches to come at this time. I did mention Medley, followed by Askinish, Greenland, Richmond, and Cocoon. Not sure you have an item or you want to say something, but I'm going to ask you, everybody, remember that the Kingdom Boys just decided that they have to take more time. So they take all of you guys 1 minute extra. So we're going to ask you to please let us just cut it down so that we can go home early. God bless you. Mike's over there.
Good evening, everyone. Let me just pause to say greetings to the platform party. Most of all, to our honored guests. I just want to take time out to say how much we love and appreciate you. The first time Reverend Samuels took you to Medley, you were welcomed. And the sermon that you preached, it was excellent. And we always look forward to hear your voice. Because whenever you come, the person's always blessed. We always blessed by your sermon. And so tonight, we are not saying goodbye because you are not dead. You are alive and well. And I'm encouraging you to hold the fort. Don't give up. Stand up on the promises of God until he comes. The songwriter said, where he leads me, I will follow. Where he leads me, I will go. When he calls me, I will answer. And I know for sure that you have answered the call that the Lord have called you. And I ask the Lord to lead you wherever he go. God bless you. We love you. We present this little token to you as a gift of love. God bless you.
Thank you so much.
Bless the Lord. Put your hands together for Medley. Bless the Lord that we invite at this time, Askinish or Greenland or Richmond and Cocoon. Please come. I'm not sure those who are prepared for an item, but if you are, please come at this time. Put your hands together for Askanish. Bless the Lord, bless the Lord.
Good night, everyone. All right, so for me, the first time I would say consciously I met Dontae was at a baptism. However, I was informed that we went to basic school together and we were very good friends. But I just did not remember. And I'm so sorry about that, Dontae. Dontae, you're not Reverend Seivwright. You're not only a pastor to me, but you're a friend as well. And you have grown on me, and you have made so much impact, not only on me, but on a lot of persons, and I really appreciate you. I just want to tell you, as Bishop said, let the word be your weapon, let the word be your guide. God will keep you. I know that it will be rough, and you are very young, but the Lord will be by your side, and you do not have to worry. Why should you worry, and why should you fear, when Jesus is the same as he was 10,000 years ago? And so I send you forth into Maypen with Clarendon, with not just physical strength, but spiritual strength, because the Lord has your back, and then you don't need anything else. God bless you.
Say, come to the water and stand by my side. He said, drink from the fountain, you won't be denied. I have seen every teardrop filled from your eyes, and I rose to tell you who your sister. He said, come ye to the waters and stand by my side. He said, drink from the fountain, you won't be denied. Oh, I have seen every teardrop that fell from your eyes, and I rose to tell you for your
small, I knew there and then that you were a purpose child,
And so I pray that the blessings of the Lord will continue to flow upon you. I pray that the good Lord will continue to direct you in the right pathway. And my word for you is tonight, don't compromise. Whatever the Lord tells you to do, do it. Amen.
Put your hands together one more time for Askanesha. Do we have any other church with a tribute? Bless the Lord, bless the Lord. Okay, so we don't have any more churches. Put your hands together for the churches who have performed and given their tributes to Pastor Dontae. We now move into another section of the tributes, and we are going to ask at this time the Young Ladies Ministry to come, followed by the Life Builders Ministry, and then we'll have the Ladies Ministry. Put your hands together as they come in this order. At this time, the Young Ladies Ministry. Put your hands together and make them welcome. Come on, everybody, put your hands together and make them welcome.
What a way, the young boy Dontae Tantal. Then no straight out a loose New Testament, Church of God. Me love when he say, Church, I feel me preaching coming on. Then hear Brother Stevens, come on. But, on a member one time, how we did love the girls. Watch righteous and sanctified Noah peep out. But there's a rumor going around in town. Say Dontae go down a hill and mash up Satan Dolly House. Now me hear say the minions are run around with death threat. Then no Dontae say already, I am covered. So Dontae, go on with your good self. Cause who God bless, no enemy can test. Bless up. Bless the Lord. Bless the Lord. I'm not gonna cry tonight. Bless the Lord. A teacher, mentor, man of God, a friend sent from above. You have been a great blessing to us here at the Lucea New Testament Church of God and everyone that you have come in touch with. We appreciate the time you have dedicated to us, even if it sometimes means you inconvenience yourself. You are indeed an amazing pastor. You have led souls to righteousness and prevented them from earthly things. You are a real gem. We pray for immeasurable blessings to abound in your ministry. We pray for sufficient grace to continue with your assignment here on earth. And I leave with you Matthew chapter 25, verse 21. It says, the master said, well done, good and faithful servant. You have been faithful with a few things. I will put you in charge of many things. Come, share your master's plan. Reverend Dontae Seivwright, you're called and appointed by God. We love you. We're going to miss you. This is not goodbye. So anywhere you're there in Bush or Clarendon, we are going to find you. And we are going to come there. Bless the Lord.
Bless the Lord. Put your hands together for the young ladies' ministry. Bless the Lord. The Life Builders Ministry, it's your time.
Bless the Lord. Good night to each and every one. One of the moments that I had feared, but it's here. I must say that my biological son is not here.
Bless the Lord. Hallelujah. Bless the Lord, oh my soul. Oh my soul. Our worship is holy name. Sing like name.
You have been somebody who would have been very close to me. I remembered when you were over there in Sunday school, and no matter how you give trouble and everything, no matter what I say to you, you still come back and say, "Sir P, all right." I'm gonna say, "Yes." I look at you as somebody who I can talk to. If you do something wrong and I correct you, that's it, and you're through. There's so many things, but for the men's department, so many times coming back from John's Hall or Montego Bay or somewhere else, I can remember you falling asleep on either Brother Troop or Brother Patterson or one of those persons. But I must say you also had showed me your signature of how your pastoral signature would have looked like. And sometimes you say to me, "Sir P, I have this sermon, what you think about it," and all of that. And as I wrap it up, I remember when you went to Bethel for the first day, and they called me and said to me that they're going to grab you. And they called, and while they called, they were saying to you that you must go home, and you must go home. And they said to me in the background, "Don't say anything to him, but we just want to see. We're going to pressure him and see if he's going to leave." But afterwards, I said to you, "You cannot come back, because you have to go forward. The call is on your life, even though others would have said to you that you're too young and everything. You still managed to go through."
I must apologize because there are some pictures with you in your wig and all kind of stuff that I would have loved to show tonight, but it's freezing up. So, also, I must say that I can depend on a call. No matter where we go, I can depend on a call from you to say, Sir P, you're reaching. When nobody else don't remember me, you always remember me. So from the men's group, we just want to say we will miss you. And the good Lord bless you as you journey to John's Hall. We will be giving you our fullest support, whether in prayer or visit. God bless you.
Yes, sir. Sir, the really, as a fact, you know, we really love you. And I can remember the days when you're away and I voice note you because I'm not good at texting, so I voice note and you're always, you know, up there. And, you know, I know that something good is going to happen. And the devil cannot sink your ship. God is the pilot of your ship. So as long as he's in the vessel, you can smile at the storm. So it's your time now to smile. To God be the glory.
Bless the Lord. When I look around and see what the Lord has done for me, it makes me want to go all the way. Sometimes my burden's heavy, sometimes I can't go through. But when I look around and see what the Lord has done for me, when I look around and see,
ladies,
what the Lord has done for me, it makes me want to go all the way. Sometimes my burden's heavy, sometimes I can't go through. But when I look around and see what the Lord has done for me,
put your hands together for the ladies. Bless.
Shall we praise the Lord? Shall we praise the Lord? Praise the Lord. All protocols observed. Dante, I'm trying not to cry. I was saying that I'm not going to cry, but Pastor Plummer tried to stir me up right now. Because the feeling I have now, sending you off into pastoral ministry, is the same feeling I had when I was sending my son off into the army. There is like a pit in my stomach. You're not my biological child, but I've said so many times, I've watched you grow from this bit up to where you are now. So it's like I've given birth to you. So it pains my heart to send you off all the way over into Clarendon. And but as the others say, you will see us again. We will come and visit you. Okay. So I am going to give you a declaration, a set of declarations that you are going to take home with you on behalf of the ladies' ministry. I boldly declare and decree this 27th day of August that you are born of the Spirit and have no confidence in the flesh. You are regenerated, redeemed, and righteous, and the causes of the kingdom of God in this earth courses through your spiritual veins. You were born to fulfill the plans, promises, and purposes of God on this earth. You are favored by God, you are fruitful, and you will flourish in the earth. You'll be an influencer and a motivator and a conqueror. You are prompted and propelled forward by the life of the Spirit who lives within you. I declare that you will make an invaluable contribution to the community, the city, the neighborhood, and the plans and purpose of God will prevail in them. Whichever community, whichever group, whichever set of people that you come with, you will prevail. I also declare that you have the courage to walk out by spiritual conviction, core values and standards wherever you go, and you refuse to be complicit with the works of evil. I also declare that you will valiantly raise the spiritual bar, and whomever you meet and wherever you go, you will stand flat-footed for God, because the God that you serve is an on-time God. He's a supernatural God. He's an omnipotent God and an omnipresent God. So you are not leaving him in Lucy to go to Clarendon. He is in Clarendon preparing the way for you. Praise God. So on behalf of the ladies' ministry, who is going to do the presentation? Sister Aries, you guard over there. While Sister Aries is doing the presentation, I have a little note here from one of your past teachers, from Rossi's. Yes. It's not very long, but Mrs. Reed says, you remember Mrs. Reed, social study Mrs. Reed? She said, please give Dontae my love and tell him that I pray God's continued blessing on his life. And tell him that I know he was going to do well because I was observing him from Rossi's. Very tiny, he always wants to preach. And there's also another one. This one is a voice note. This is from our sister Jennifer. She is in Canada. And she sent me this to play for you.
Good evening, everyone. Time won't allow me to write what I want to say to Brother Dontae this evening. This is Sister Jennifer, and I just want to say congratulations to you and taking up your position as an old reverend into a new church, a new environment that you do not know. But I know that there is a God who watches over you, and that God that keeps you at Lucy New Testament Church is going to keep you in the Spanish Town New Testament Church, where the Lord has appointed you to be. May God continue to guide and keep and protect you. And you're always in my prayers, Brother Dontae Seivwright. I love you with the love of the Lord. As you can hear it in my voice, I am crying because I know I'm going to miss you. And I love you. I love you. I love you so much, Brother Dontae. God bless you.
Okay, sorry for the Spanish tone. She didn't get the update. All
right. Pastor Seivwright. All right, he's warning me. Don't talk about Rossi's. I won't. Okay, Pastor Seivwright, on behalf of the ladies' ministry. Off air, Pastor. On behalf of the ladies' ministry, I want to present to you this token as a sign of our love and appreciation for you. Dontae, I don't know, you're lovable. And it's easy to love you if you really... if you really get to understand you, it's easy to love you. And you're brilliant. You are very proactive. I admire you. And clearly, from school, leadership qualities were there. And you embraced it, and you are walking in your purpose. God bless you as he leads you to lead his people. Be mindful of that. It's God's people, and he's depending on you to lead them. God bless you.
Hi,
Bless the Lord. One more time, put your hands together for the ladies, the young women's ministry, and the life builders ministry. We are coming down nicely. Please don't go. Realize persons are leaving. So at this time, I'm going to invite the family of Dontae, Seivwright to come, and they'll be doing their special tribute at this time. Put your hands together for a proud family coming to do their tribute. Put your hands together. Bless the Lord. Bless the Lord. Please come. Bless the Lord.
Lord. Amen. This is Auntie Empress, all the way from London, England. Right. Dontae, as I said, my boy, every time, my boy. Right. Dontae. And I love you. I love you. What more can I say? Though the world seems so feeble and small, and I love you, I love you with all of my heart, and to love you
Lord. Can we just lift your hands and just wave them and just bless the Lord? Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Good night, everyone. Well, I don't have a gift for Dontae tonight. Well, I must say that I had big plans for him to get him a big gift. But as you know, what happened on Saturday, I was out of it. I couldn't do much, but I cared for him. You see, you can see him looking all dapper. Yes, it's all because of me. Yes, from head to toe, I did everything. From the accident, I have been a nurse. I wanted to be a nurse, but I was afraid of the blood. And when I was caring for him, he said to me, "Mommy, why the nurse in the hospital can't care for me like how you care for me?" And I'm telling you that I am tired, but I cared for Dontae from he came home. I didn't 1 minute let him feel like I am tired. I didn't show it. I gave him breakfast. I gave him pill. I gave him lunch. I gave him his pill. I gave him dinner. I wake up. I put him to sit up. I put him to lay down. I put him in the chair. I did everything, and I was saying, look, like me can be one nurse, you know, but that is not only what nurses require to do. So, and I'm really old right now, so I can't study again, yes, but I just want to say, when Dontae said he wanted to go to Bethel, I said to him, I'm going to send you to come see first to do a degree in business, and he said, Mommy, after you make me do that degree, I'm going to go to Bethel. And when he said that, I was saying, oh, it don't make no sense. Can we go waste all that money? And he's just doing it because I'm sending him. And I don't know what happened, but we just started shopping for him to go to Bethel. We bought everything. And when he went to Bethel, they were looking at him like, really? He took everything to Bethel. I onboard everything. And I am happy that I allowed him to do what he wanted to do, because he is really called and he would not give up on that calling. And I'm happy I did not stop him from going to Bethel. I am a happy, happy mother today. Looking at my baby, I am happy. And I will not cry tonight because I don't have any tears left. From Saturday, I cried. So I'm happy tonight. I will not cry. Love you all. Thank you.
Bless the Lord. Thank you very much. I know invite the church representative from the church's church's office to come and make their presentation. Then we'll have open presentation. People, we are out of time. So I'm giving anybody come in, you just have 1 minute to do so, including the church, because based on what I understand, it will not be a long presentation. So following the church, we'll have Samantha and her daughter come in. And if we have any more open tribute, I'm saying you have less than a minute to do so. So at this time, the church.
Hallelujah. Good evening again, my sisters and brothers, visiting friends. Good evening to our honored guests. Good evening, sir. Okay, so my bishop, God bless you, sir. Yes, sir. On behalf of Brother Dontae, Pastor Dontae, as we know, I know you as Dontae, but now you are Pastor Dontae. So we just want to give God thanks for you, sir. And as I said before, as long as he's steering your ship, he is in control of your life. And Brother Dontae, Pastor Dontae, when you go into your church, you remember that you are the leader of God's people. Let nobody intimidate you, because the Spirit of God is with you. God bless you, sir, and I hope and trust that whatsoever you say or do, it will come straight from the bottom of your heart. God bless you.
Bless the Lord. Put your hands together. Bless the Lord. Hallelujah. We take Sister Samantha and her daughter. And if we have any more open tribute, please line up just and behind and come.
Good night, everyone. Pastor Dontae, the D for me, dapper, tidy and stylish, dazzling, brilliantly attractive, dynamic, positive in attitude and full of energy in the Spirit of the Lord, dear for last, beloved, esteemed and precious.
Reverend Dontae, life is a song, sing it. Life is a race, run it. Life is a challenge, meet it. Life is a dream, realize it. Life is a sacrifice, offer it. Life is love, enjoy it. Your farewell is a bittersweet moment. Nevertheless, I rejoice and cheer you on. You have taught me so much, whether directly or indirectly, and it's safe to say you made a positive impact on my life. For that, I'm grateful. You're such a blessing in disguise, and so I know wherever you go, you'll make a difference. So on behalf of Mommy and I present to you this gift, this token. May God maintain his blessing upon you and help you tread on the future path with ease and comfort.
Bless the Lord. Put your hands together for them. Bless the Lord. And we now have his aunt, Juni.
Brother Dontae, yes. You know I love you very much, yes. And you always encourage me to stay with God. God bless you.
Bless the Lord. Put your hands together for her as we welcome Sister Sherman Walker-Shaw.
Pastor Dontae, a brother in Christ, a son, I love you. And as you embarked on your new journey, I just want to tell you to stand in God, be firm in God, do what God wants you to do. It's not by might, it's not by power, but by my spirit, said the Lord.
And I know that you will do well as long as you ground yourself in God. So I send you off with the blessings of the Lord, and let the Lord continue to guide you in all truth. And we love you.
I love you too.
Bless the Lord. And we also have one more. Bless the Lord.
Reverend Dante, I'm standing in proxy for Tina. This is from Tina Shea. To a man called and sent by God, Reverend Seivwright, it saddens me that I cannot be there physically to share in your transition service. Nonetheless, I give God thanks that I am still here and is able to share via social platform. As you go off into full-time ministry, I want to remind you that God did not just put purpose inside of you. He also placed protection around you. With that, I want you to remember, as much as you are excited for the assignment and can't wait to see God's people being saved, be cautioned, that throughout this journey, swords will be raised against you. Take comfort nonetheless, knowing Yahweh Sabaoth is always and is will be with you. Also, as you now sit in a superior seat, your main role always is to serve. Be the servant leader that is selfless, humble, apologetic, empathetic, diligent, attentive, prayerful, reliable, authoritative, and confident. I am proud of you. I am praying for you. Great work awaits, but he who is sending you is greater. For every praise we are tempted to give you, we will remember to let it go to Calvary. God bless you. From
bless
Tina
the
Shea.
Lord. Bless the Lord. Hallelujah. Bless the Lord. And it's now time to hear from Dontae, Pastor Dontae. But I just want to say, just 30 seconds, is that I've also watched Dontae growing. Everybody said a lot of things, but I want to say that, you know, I have seen Dontae preach in Lucea. I've seen him preach in the parish. I've seen Dontae preach out of parish. And for me, I am so blessed when I heard that Dontae would have been preaching at National Convention. And I think God's hand is on him. And I have been watching him. Every time they have something on Dontae going over foreign, I get the link and I watch it overseas. And I am just so proud of Dontae. From a long time, everybody know that Dontae give trouble. From a long time, we know that in Sunday school, him really give trouble. And when we ask questions, Dontae think him know all of the answers and all of that. But so he was always showing from a long time that me a dapper and that me a up there and that I'm going to do it and I'm going to do well. But one of the amazing things is that he understand the call of God. And that's amazing. As a young man, I am richly blessed by his ministry thus far. And I know there's great things. I told him that I would see him preach at convention. And I told him also that I'm expecting one of these days that he will be the bishop of the New Testament Church of God. And I'm speaking it into being. Let us welcome at this time Pastor Dontae Seivwright.
Well, could you put your hands together for the moderator, everybody? Well, I'm searching for words to respond. And as I search for words to respond, one of the first words that come to my mind is the word grateful. And really grateful I am to celebrate tonight as I am being celebrated. And I want to thank all of you for your kind words so far, as you continue to encourage me as I seek to go out into full-time ministry. I want to respond in such a way tonight, firstly, by just thanking God for sparing my life so that I could respond tonight. Could we put our hands above our heads and give God a clap offering in the house? My brothers and sisters, I stood to respond at my send-off service in Maypen, and I will echo the same words I echoed there, that truly I am not all that. And every praise you would have for me, let it go to Calvary. I am really just a testament of the grace of God on my life. Nothing good I have done, but God in his wise providence and in his omnipresence, omnipotence, and omniscience indeed looked down on a young man like me, chose me, and because of God, I am. Could we double that hand clap again and give our God praise in the house? Want to, I'm not seeing my bishop, but I want to, I understand. I want to celebrate Bishop Williams, and he will get to watch this over again, for the work he has done where I am concerned. Bishop came here after Bishop Samuel sent me off to Bible college, and Bishop has not dropped the ball. He has been a father, a mentor. He recommended me to the ministry, though Bishop Sam recommended me to Bethel. He signed me up for credential, and he gave me his blessing, and here I am today because of what Bishop Williams has done for me. Could we put our hands together for our pastor and for some of us, our district overseer? I want to give God thanks for all the tributes that have gone forth tonight. My brothers and sisters, as you know, Saturday gone should have been the date for sunset for Dontae Seivwright, but here I am another week celebrating the goodness of God and going forth to Clarendon to pastor God's people as I carry out God's mandate. I thank you for your prayers. I thank you for your love, and I thank you for your support. As I respond tonight, I want everyone to know that the difference with responding at Maypen versus responding in Lucy is that Maypen got me when I was a fourth-year student finishing up internship to go in the ministry. But as I respond here, I am responding to my home. I am responding to a place where they knew me from Sunday school when I was a well-behaved child. I am responding to a set of people who I have never given trouble in VBS. I am responding to a set of people who we have all had good times where Dontae is concerned. We're responding to a set of people who, when they coach me for teens Bible quiz, they love me and can't stop loving me. That's the set of people I'm responding to, because they indeed trained me from a little child. I thank God for my Sunday school teachers. I thank God for the persons who corrected me. I thank God for the persons who helped me from being a little child who is just flamboyant and anxious and annoying to a young man who is ready to go and serve God's people at the age of 21. Lucy New Testament Church, thank you. Thank you. Thank you. As I respond, there's one thing that bothers the preacher, and I must raise it in my response, is that after we conclude tonight, I will seek to set a meeting with Sister Slowly just to work out the part that says, I love all the girls. I don't know about that. I am not guilty of that. And she and I will have to talk. Is that an amen, somebody? Sister Slowly, I love you. And God bless you. Thank you for such a poem. And indeed, my heart is touched. God bless you. You know that since you came here, you have been a great inspiration. And God continue to use you to bless me as I in turn seek to encourage you. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. Put your hands together for Sister Slowly. Want to thank God for the young women ministry who continue to just be a cut above the rest. They are just amazing people, and I thank God for them. Auntie Jensia, God bless you. You and your ministry. I love you so much. And I thank God for the way you have used me, encouraged me, and allowed me to develop. I give God thanks for the council. I give God thanks for Sister Williams. I give God thanks for just about everybody who has contributed to my life. But there are two men in the house that I must single out. Of course, Reverend Gordon and Reverend Plummon. When I say I have to single them out, I mean I have to single them out. These two men have basically fathered me. And as I was a little young man, just passionate and zealous for God, they have helped to curve me. They have helped to show me the way. They have taught me what it means to become a young man, to be responsible, to move from teenage into adulthood. And I celebrate the work that you have done in my life. And also, I can also call them brother as much as I can call them fathers. And I give God thanks for them. I am, because you are. Brother Plummer, God bless you richly. And I love you sincerely. And Reverend Garden, in Jesus' name. Could you put your hands together for them, everybody? Sending you home shortly, but also I want to give God thanks for my family. My family has done a wonderful job in allowing me to become the person I am today. I want to give God thanks for my father, who I made up in my mind that he had to be saved before I left Lucy. And look what the Lord has done. Praise God. And I thank God for such a father. And I was telling mommy that since daddy got saved, even our father to son relationship has gotten extremely better, because we talk the same. We are talking about the same things, and our conversations are about God. God bless you, daddy, and I love you. Love you, mommy. Thank you for all you have done. Thank you for your support. Thank you, grandma. Thank you, Auntie Carrie, Auntie Rika, Trina. Everybody, thank you. God bless you richly, and I love you and love you sincerely. My sisters and brothers, I want to thank God for the Robinson sisters and all those who continue to play a big role in my life. Auntie Yvonne, Auntie Tanisha, Auntie Bev. Alyssa is not an auntie to me. Alyssa and all the others. Kelissa, put your hands together for Kelissa, everybody. She's truly one of my favorite people at Lucy New Testament Church. Yeah, man, that's my sister. And I love her. I love her dearly. Kelissa, God bless you. Alice, I love you too. But I really love Kelissa. Oh, praise God. Oh, praise God. I want to ask Leandra and Tylo to stand. Leandra is still here? Yeah, she's standing in the media room. My brothers and sisters, God has spoken to me. And he spoke to me in such a way that he asked me to make Tylo and Leandra my responsibility in terms of ensuring that they are not among the rest who backslide. Even if they come back, these are two persons who God's hands are resting on. And God opened my eyes, showed them to me. And many of you don't know, we're in a group called, I've made a group for them called Girls of Promise, where I have assigned Leandra to Kelissa and assigned Tylo to Tina Shea. And behind the scene, they are being mentored, and God has done an extremely great work in their life. And every time I think about the fact that I will have to lose the ties a bit and allow them to grow and to be God's people, I just want to say thank you for allowing me to be obedient to God as I sought to pour into your life. And I ask you, please, take backsliding off your list, because God has great, great, great plans for you, and I'm depending on you. God bless you. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. I know time is going. I'm going to ask the boys to stand. I'm going to ask all the boys to stand. All the boys, please stand. As I walked in today, for those of you who weren't here as I did my entrance, as I walked in, the aisles were paved with young men. And as I walked in, these young men saluted me. Reverend Garden, I don't think you were here. As I walked in, these young men, they saluted me. And Brother Plummer came and meet me and did one of them fireman drill and salute and brought me up, you know, and allowed me to feel like a dignitary. But as they did that, I thought about the fact that I should be saluting you guys. You guys have made me look good. Because of the Kingdom Boys Club in Lucy, this has taken on a national ministry. Because of the few of you guys, there is now a national boys club ministry in Jamaica from the head office level. And permit me to tell you that because of these young men and because of a vision, I now serve as the chairman for Jamaica for the National Boys Ministry in the New Testament Church of God. Young men, keep your heads up. Don't backslide. Don't give up. Don't stop coming to church because I'm absent. Serve God. Keep his commandment. Make God proud and make me proud. God bless you in Jesus' name. I really cannot single out everybody. What I want to say to Sister Aries and to bring it back to Rossi's, all the teachers who sent their love, and Sister Nerva, please give them my love as well. I was a really good behaving boy at Rossi's, and they saw the prospect. Amen. I mean, it couldn't be anything else in Jesus' name. But my brothers and sisters, God bless you richly. Want to thank you all for coming out tonight to celebrate me. Want to thank God for Sister Vera and Sister Randall and all those old mothers, Sister Hermine, who continue to pray for me. Permit me to respond. I have to. Brother Stevens, God bless you, because truly after this week, I am out in Clarendon. Please permit me. Brother Atkinson, all of you, I love you dearly. Brother Powell, and just about everybody. Sister Lewis, God bless you richly. But I want to say to... I want to close this way, if I'm allowed to. I want to give God thanks for Sister Tina Shea Solomon, as she sent such a perfect paragraph in her absence. I think it is quite fitting to respond to such a charge by expressing my gratitude. I express this also with clarity, because she was in the same accident I was in. And though I can come back and stand here, she's still in a hospital bed. And so I want to give God thanks for her in the fact that she could write like that, charge me like that, even though I am in a much better circumstance than she is. I call that strength. And I declare over her that healing is coming. And I pray that God will have his way in her life as we declare that she indeed will recover and recover well. Sisters and brothers, any praise you'd have for me, let it go to Calvary in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. God bless you.
The Lord bless you and keep you. Make his face shine upon you.
We invite the hearers at this time to come to do the vote of thanks. Turn his face toward you and give you peace. Amen. 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 Amen.
The task is mine to express thanks. Virgin, you can see. This event would not have been possible without the input of everyone here tonight. Thank you all for attending. I'm sure you were motivated to come because of your love and appreciation for Dontae, Pastor Seivwright. Special thanks to our moderator, Sister Brown, for so ably leading us through the program. Special thanks to our moderator, Sister Brown, for so ably leading us through the program. We want to say thanks to the praise team for leading us into a moment of praise and worship. Reverend Plummer, for invoking the presence of the Lord through prayer and scripture reading. Timothy 4, 11 to 16, let no man despise thy youth. Sister Celine, for her presentation in dance. Surely, it's not by might nor by power, but it's by the Spirit of the Lord. Sister Cunningham for introducing the night speaker, who was our Bishop Williams, who brought the charge to Reverend Seivwright. Stay in God's love. Keep yourself in the love of God. Be convinced about God's love for you. Keep your heart warm with the love of God. Greetings came to us from Reverend Marlando Gordon and his wife and brother pastor, student pastor, Larry Anderson. Special thanks to those persons who brought tributes. And the tributes all expressed love, admiration. They spoke of a young man who is zealous for God. And we say thanks to those persons tonight from the different churches, Askinish, Greenland, Dundepen, and all the persons who brought tributes tonight. We appreciate it and we thank you that you made the effort to be here tonight. And of course, I'm sure you just thinking about Dontae was enough to push you to come out tonight. And we are very happy. Indeed, it was a night well spent. Do you agree with me? Yes, it was a night well spent. And I'm sure that Reverend Seivwright is going off to Sandy Bay with a little bit of warmth in his heart. John's Hall in Clarendon with a little bit of warmth in his heart tonight. Reverend Seivwright, be reminded that there's a church in Lucea and a people in Lucea that is praying for you. And we know that you are going to do well. You're gifted and talented, and the hand of God is on you. It was very clear from a young age. The only thing you ever wanted to do was to preach. And it is, I am sure that you are going to be mighty for God. Don't be too concerned about where you're placed right now. You are going to be mighty for God. And I'm waiting. I hope I live long enough to see it. I know that you're going to be great. And so to everybody tonight, thank you all for coming out. If you weren't here, we couldn't have the function. So we appreciate you all. Thank you for being here with us tonight. And I know that you enjoyed what happened. And as we're about to go in the presence of the Lord. God bless you all.
Bless the Lord. Bless the Lord. And we are out of time. So invite you all to stand. I'm going to ask Leandra and Cara to come. We are going to do the song, The Lord Bless You. Those who did not get the chance to shake his hand, that's our benediction song. We'll do the song as you go. You have the opportunity. Remember, he's not 100, so don't shake too hard. Just, you know, be gentle. And I'm going to ask Leandra and Cara to come and join Alyssa and Orlean and Tanisha to do The Lord Bless You and Keep You. The Lord Make His Face Shine Upon You.
And keep you, make his face shine upon you.
Please, you can come now and just shake hands or whatever you want to do. Please come.
The Lord turn his face towards you and give you peace. Face towards you and
His favor be upon you and a thousand generation, and your family, and your children, and your children, and your children. May His favor go before you and behind you and beside you, all around you and within you. He's with you, He's with you in the morning, in the evening, in the coming and the going, in your weeping and rejoicing. He's for you, 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 He's for you. All around you and within you, He's with you, He's with you in the morning and the evening, in your coming and your going, in your weeping and rejoicing. He's for you, He's for you.
Amen.
The Lord.